is acting on gravity dam, where in the lecture, the discussion part or the discussion content was about the uplift pressure, the weight of dam, and the water pressure. So these are the three major pressure or the forces acting on the gravity dam has been discussed in earlier video. So today I will be going to discuss our next major forces which are acting, which does act on the gravity dam. So the major force which we have to consider while designing is earthquake. So before concentrating on earthquake pressure, we need to know that earthquake force will come as a dynamic force. So what is dynamic force? Well, dynamic force and static force, the difference between these two forces are that dynamic force will change with the change of time wave. So how does we calculate the seismic force? Well, seismic force is equal to the mass into the earthquake acceleration. Well, what is the mass? Well, mass is the mass of the structure you are basically working on. So in this manner we will calculate the seismic force. So according to IS 1893-2002, basically this has been changed, the amendment has already been done to 2016. Here these four zones are categorized. Well, these four zones, these four zones are the representation of the severity or the occurrence of the earthquake in the in our country. So let me show you this picture, then it will be quite easier to understand. Just see, the darker the color, mean the reddish one, the red colored location are representing the most severe cases of earthquake in the previous history. So in the last 100 or 50 years history, these are the places where the earthquake has given a devastated example. So this red color comes under zone 5. Then the orange color, this zone is lesser than the zone 4, the severity in the severity basis. These orange color representing the zone 4, and the yellow part is representing zone 3, and the second part is representing zone 2. Well, the last one, zone 2, which has been represented by the sky color, this is in these places, the severity or the devastation of due to earthquake and the failure of the structure has occurred is minimum. Okay, so these zone wise, where you need to say in say you have got a project, so the location of that project comes under zone 4. So under that, following that, you have to consider all the design procedure and you have to adopt all the earthquake resistance protocol in order to construct that kind of that dam structure. Okay, so well, earthquake force, we have to actually I will be going to show you by the two category. By one is how you will be evaluating the vertical acceleration, vertical earthquake acceleration, and another one is the how to evaluate the horizontal acceleration. Well, let us just read it out once. That if the dam to be designed is to be located in a region which is susceptible to earthquakes, allowance must be made for the stresses generated by earthquakes. An earthquake produces waves which are capable of shaking the earth upon which the dam is resting in every possible direction. The effect of an earthquake is therefore equivalent to imparting an acceleration to the foundation dam in the direction in which the wave is traveling moment. So in this, what I have already said, that the two acceleration, one horizontal acceleration and vertical acceleration, are induced by earthquake. So here the values of these acceleration are generally expressed as percentage of the acceleration due to gravity. Well, this alpha are the fraction, this is actually the representation of the horizontal acceleration and the vertical acceleration, and this horizontal and vertical acceleration will be expressed by some fraction of the gravitational load or gravitational acceleration of our earth. This will be some fraction of that. That force will be some fraction of the gravitational load. Okay, in very severe cases, we basically adopt this to be 0.3 g, but in a very nominal case, we generally consider this alpha to be 0.1 g to 0.15 g. See, there are some examples which are given that 0.1 to 0.15 g is generally sufficient for high damp seismic zones. A value equal to 0.15 g has been used in Bhakra dam and 0.2 g in Ramganga dam design. And for extreme places where it comes in zone 5, in such cases that a dam has been considered to be taken alpha as 0.3 g. Okay, in extreme case. Okay, so effect, let us study about the effect of the vertical acceleration. Well, let me just draw it. It will be then much. See, this is the dam, okay. And this is the foundation. So now what happens? We are discussing about the vertical acceleration, right? So now consider the earthquake, that earthquake wave is coming in a vertical direction. Okay. So in vertical direction, it may create a force in upward or downward as well. So you may not know that in which direction it may happen. So what happens? If the direction is in upward, then what happens? That part of the foundation on which the structure is resting, that part of foundation is creating a upward force along with the weight of the dam. So here the net effective stress or the net effective weight will increase automatically, because that part of foundation is creating upward force along with the dam structure. So the effective stress or the effective weight will increase. And if that direction becomes in downward part, then what happen? Just a minute. So if the direction of the force occurs in downward way, then what happened? That this part of the foundation on which that structure is resting, that will try to separate, right? This will try to come in this direction. So it will try to separate from this structure, that part of foundation will try to be get separated from this structure. So what happened in that case? The net effective stress or the net effective weight will try to get reduced. Okay, in that case, that scenario will be opposite. So in that case, just come into the calculation part. See, this thing has been expressed in this part, that when the vertical acceleration is acting downward, the foundation shall try to move downward away from the dam body, thus reducing the effective weight and the stability of the dam, and hence is worst case for designs. vertical direction occurs in downward way, this is more devastated than the upward direction. That is why that calculation has been adopted considering this scenario. See, sorry. Such acceleration will therefore exert an inertia force. Mean that due to that chunk of or that part of foundation will try to get separated or away from this body, this body was attached to this foundation, right? So this body will also try to fall or go with this foundation part. So that inertia force will actually try to go with its original position. Just a minute. Okay. So what happens that this is W by G. What is W? W is the total weight of dam. Okay. So this is nothing but the mass. So what we know that our W is nothing but mg, or F is ma, what we have studied. So A is G. So here we can write that M to W by G. So M here, see that effective stress will be reduced. That how much will be reduced? So in that force is nothing but created by that earthquake. And we have already studied that seismic force is equal to the mass into acceleration. So in this case, that acceleration is nothing but a vertical acceleration, which is represented as alpha v. So this is m into g, actually the gravitational force in vertical direction. This is represented as alpha v. So this m can be represented as w by g, and that mg's g can be represented by alpha v. So this is the changed part due to the seismic force. So this is mg. Actually, this is m, this is g. So now the net effective weight of the dam is what we knew, that it was w initially before the earthquake force. It was w when the earthquake force coming in the downward way, it creates a wave in a downward direction. That net effective will effective stress or the weight will be reduced. So how much weight will be reduced? It will be w by g into alpha v. So this was our reduced part. Okay, it will try to get reduced. So if we take common this w out of this, so what we can get, it is 1 minus alpha v by g. Okay, now we know that alpha v is equal to kv into g. Now what is kv? Kv is the fraction of gravity adopted for vertical acceleration, such as 0.1, 0.2, what we have discussed in the previous in the earlier slide. So it can be 0.1, 0.2 of some 0.1 or 0.2 g. Okay, that alpha v can be anything. So 0.1 or 0.2 g. So if we put that value in this place, so we will get w minus w by g into kv into g. So g and g will be cut, and after that the simplified expression we will get to be w into 1 minus kv. So in this way we will calculate the net effective weight of the dam. Okay, so is there any problem in this place to understand? Please you can tell me. Okay, so let me get into the next part, which is horizontal acceleration. See, in this place the acceleration the direction of that force is coming in a vertical way. It can be downward or upward. See, in this place the earthquake force will be coming in this horizontal way, right? It can be come in this direction or that direction. Okay, so let us study about in this direction, because why we are considering this direction, we'll come to that. That horizontal, when we are considering the horizontal force hitting at this structure, two major part will get affected. What is that? One is the inertia force of this gravity dam, because this will try to rest in its original position. When a earthquake, horizontal earthquake force will try to struck it down, try to hit in this direction, it will to rest, keep, it will try to stay in its original position, but it will be moved out if the horizontal force is greater than that push. So this inertia force or that horizontal inertial force will be one major thing, and another one is the water retained in that part, right? That water will create a hydrodynamic pressure on this surface or on this wall of the dam. Okay, so these two major pressure will be created in as a effect of horizontal acceleration. So let us read about that. That first we will study about the hydrodynamic pressure. So the horizontal acceleration acting towards the reservoir causes a momentary increase in water pressure. Just a minute. As the foundation and dam accelerate towards the reservoir and the water resists the movement owing to its inertia, the extra pressure exerted by this process is known as hydrodynamic pressure. Well, this hydrodynamic pressure has been amounted by actually scientist Von Karman. He has proposed that hydrodynamic pressure, which is represented as PE, can be stated as this, which is 0.555 kh gamma w into h square. Well, what is kh here? So kh here is nothing but, see, in the previous one for vertical acceleration, kv was the fraction of gravity adopted for vertical acceleration. Now the kh is the fraction of gravity adopted for the horizontal acceleration. This is nothing but that fraction of horizontal acceleration into gamma w into h square. Well, in the similar way we have discussed in the water pressure, right? It was half into gamma w into h square. So in that, this is the similar part. See the similarities in the pressure. So see, that hydrodynamic pressure will form in the way of elliptical way, right? So in the elliptical way, the CG distance, just a minute, that CG distance, that height will be from the bottom will be 4 by 3 pi of h, which is 0.424 h. At this distance, that PE will act at the surface of this part of the dam. So showing the development of hydrodynamic pressure by horizontal earthquake moving towards the reservoir. A similar pressure will be developed on downstream tailwater when the earthquake is reserved. So in this part, if any tailwater exists, so this will also occur in a similar way. Okay, that hydrodynamic pressure will be created at a very similar way. Okay, so where kh is the fraction, I have discussed it. So what will be the moment? So now you know this pressure. Okay, now you know the distance. So the force into distance will give me a moment at this point. So it will try to create a moment at this point. So that moment about the base will be e into 4h by 3 pi. So that distance, so multiplying that 0.555 into kh into gamma w into h square into 4 by 3 pi h will give me this value. This is the simplified one. You can calculate it in your copy, then you will get the same value. Okay. Okay, so up to this, is there any problem? So the seismic coefficient, what we have studied is alpha h, which is horizontal seismic coefficient, and vertical seismic coefficient is alpha v. So alpha h is generally considered to be point, alpha v is generally considered to be 0.75 of alpha h, means 75% of alpha h. So we have to consider in that way generally. So alpha h can be determined by one of the two methods. So the first one is seismic coefficient method, which we have to consider when the height of dam will be less than 100 meter, and the other method, which is called the response spectrum method, this we have to adopt when the height of dam is more than 100 meter. Okay, so these are two methods which we have to calculate while designing the dam in the direction of horizontal way. Okay, so the next one is wave pressure. So this is also another important one. So the waves are generated on the surface of the reservoir by the blowing winds. So basically the wave occurs due to the blowing winds, which causes a pressure toward the downstream side. So that is the extra pressure without the, I mean, this is the extra pressure without the reserved water or the stored water created. Okay, so where was I? So if you consider this height to be HW is the height of water from top of crease to bottom of trough in meters. So how could we calculate that HW? How can we calculate? By knowing two parameters. So one is if you know the wind velocity, and the other is the fetch or straight length of the water expanse in kilometer, mean that how long the water is expanded, that fetch or straight length and the wind velocity. Knowing these two parameters, we can calculate the HW or the height of the wave. So see, HW is equal to 0.032 root over V into F plus 0.763 minus 0.271 into F to the power 3 by 4. This HW shall be considered when the F, mean the fetch or straight length of water expanse, is less than 32 kilometer, and when it is greater than 32 kilometer, then we have to avoid this part. We can calculate by only this part only, 0.032 root over V into F. Okay, so now this is HW. So above, and this is the length of still water. So above the still water, this part is 2/3 of HW, and this part is 1/3 of HW. Now that pressure will basically make a curvilinear form, but in this case, for the ease of calculation, that pressure have been considered in a triangular shape. Okay. See, maximum pressure intensity due to wave action may be given to be 2.4 gamma W into HW. So this has been already calculated. which acts at hw by 2 meter above the still water surface. Means, see here, this pw is acting at hw by 2. See, this is here, this part is 1 by 8th of hw, okay, and this part is 3/8 of hw. So if you just add 3/8 plus 1/8, so you will actually get 1 by 2 or half of the hw by 2. So this is actually acting at this part, okay. So this is giving me that pw. So this is the pw. The value is 2.4 gamma w into h. So this is 2.4 gamma w into h. Now, in order to evaluate the stress at the cg distance, means this triangle cg distance will be acting at this point, okay. So we have to calculate, we have to calculate that distance. See, this part, this is a triangle. So we know that base part, which is 2.4 gamma w hw. So we can calculate that intensity by calculating the area of the triangle, which is half into base into height. So here, half into that base is 2.4 gamma w hw into height. So here, height is nothing but this. 1/3 of hw. This is the height. Okay. So in this manner, we can evaluate the total force due to wave action, which will act at this point. Okay. It will act at this point. So if we know that part, so we can calculate the total force due to the wave action. So now here, see that pw is equal to 2 into gamma w into h square w, mean this part. See here, this part is 2 gamma w h square w, mean this part has been calculated in this way. If you calculate this furthermore, you will get this equation, okay, or this expression. So putting the value of the gamma w is equal to 9.81, we can further get this represent value, which is 19.62 hw square kilonewton per meter. This force acts at the distance of 3/8 hw above the reservoir surface. Mean this is the still water, so above this surface this force will act, okay. So this has already measured in the book or the calculation. You don't have to calculate by it yourself. You can put the value and in the calculator, then you will get this value. Just solve it, you can get this value here.